And good morning again, Bishop Ryan, and welcome back to another busy week. And it all begins today with our girls' hockey team playing for the city championship at 1 p.m. location, Mountain Arena. This event is only available to students who have purchased a ticket on School Cash Online. There will not be any tickets sold at the door. Anyone without a ticket will be turned away. Bishop Ryan, this is also a very good opportunity for us to speak about our conduct as fans in the stands. We've been blessed as a school to be athletically and artistically gifted with lots of opportunities to showcase and celebrate our successes and achievements. But with great success and great opportunities to witness those accomplishments as they occur comes a great responsibility to celebrate with respect and good nature. To say that I was disgusted by the actions and the foul language by our fan base at the boys' hockey championship last Wednesday would be a complete understatement. I expect for every fan that chooses to come to any game our teams play to act responsibly, cheer positively, and have respect for the venue that we're playing in. No swearing, no littering, no negative words or actions towards our opponent or the referees. Treat the stands and the fans respectfully. This is not the NHL or some other professional sports league. This is a Catholic high school event that comes with a particular decorum that must be maintained. It is important for me as a Bishop Ryan graduate and as your principal to have you join us as spectators during these events. But I will not have our student fans disrespect the good name of Bishop Ryan or the hard work of our athletes who are out on the ice or in the future on the field. If we cannot behave as fans, Bishop Ryan, we will just stop having buy-in opportunities for you to witness these monumental events. I'm happy to give you an opportunity again today to show me that what I saw at the boys' hockey championship was a mistake. If I find that it wasn't, and that we're not understanding each other today, we will just stop providing buy-in opportunities. So, cheer positively today, Bishop Ryan, and represent your school and our team with the same pride that is mentioned in our motto, where faith, pride, and effort promote excellence. There are a lot of other great events that are happening this week that you are going to hear about more about on these announcements, including tomorrow's Black History Month showcase, which you won't want to miss, and a Celtic-free bake sale that's occurring on Thursday. Also worth noting is that this Wednesday, March the 1st, is the birthday of our patron, Bishop Joseph Francis Ryan. Bishop Ryan was a big supporter of Catholic education in our city and in the province. Under his watch, our board added 5 high schools, including this one here, in 1958. Bishop Ryan is long dead, but on Wednesday, we celebrate his 126th birthday in recognition of his accomplishments. Lastly, this Friday, March the 3rd, is a PD day. All students will remain at home on this day, catching up on schoolwork and studying. Our staff will be engaging in a faith day to develop our spiritual wellness and fuel us as your Catholic educators. Wishing you a good start to the week, Bishop Ryan, and now for more WRBR. 3, 2, 1.
Whoa there, BR. You snuck up on me. I'm Nick, and here's your morning announcement today.
Oh, hey, Lawler.
Looking for community service hours. Planning to get involved in the upcoming Fast for Justice, Thursday, March 9th. Don't forget about your permission forms into Chaplain Thompson as soon as possible, as the deadline for permission forms is Wednesday, March 1st. Next announcement today. Hey, Celtics, it's time for you to choose your courses for September. Step 1 is to pay your $40 activation fee on School Cash Online. Step 2 is to choose your courses on My Blueprint. Please choose now and avoid disappointment later. Students choosing co-op will register a priority on March 1st. Other students will go see their Period 1 teachers for Step 2 registration on March 2nd. Make an appointment if you have any questions. Attention all grads, if you wish to pay cash for your grad fees, please pay Ms. Mazza and Student Services. The deadline is fast approaching. And that's all from me. Have a good week, BR. Follow at WRBR.news for all your Celtic stories. Stay tuned for more WRBR.
Attention all grade 12 students. School Cash Online is soon closing to pay your grad fee. The deadline to pay the grad fee is March 3rd, which is this Friday.
Due to timing, a $10 late fee will be charged after Friday. No grad fees will be accepted after Friday, March the 10th.
The grad portrait schedule is released on the graduation LMS page and can be seen on the TVs throughout the day. Remember to arrive 5 minutes early to the auditorium dressed in a white t-shirt or blouse. Ties are optional.
Finally, any graduates who ordered grad sweaters will be notified once they have arrived, so stay tuned.
That's all from the grad committee. Stay tuned for more WRBR.
Good morning, Bishop Ryan. Happy Monday. So cool to have a little lead in there to all things musical here at Bishop Ryan. Mr. Lawler said it. We have this amazing tradition at BR of athletic and artistic excellence. So please, if you are in the stands today, do another fellow BR grad a favor and represent our school with class and dignity. Listen, it is Monday, and I'm here to give you the week that is in Bishop Ryan. So first and foremost, Drumline, who will be playing today at the girls' game, is asked to go to the music room right after announcements and meet with Mr. Pickley. We need to see who's available. So members of the Drumline, please, right after announcements, head to the music room for a very quick meeting with Mr. Pickley. After school today, the Celtic Fusion will have a rehearsal. And Fusion, I'll mention it today, but we'll probably start going a little bit longer in our rehearsals in the area of 3:45 to 4 o'clock as we get ready for our gala shows, and I'll talk about that in just 1 second. So Celtic Fusion Concert Band after school today, and BR Expression Vocal Ensemble rehearsing on Wednesday after school. It's a huge season for BR as we get ready for the return of our in-person gala concerts, which have not happened in 3 years, and I can't tell you how excited I am for that. The feeder schools are starting to reply, and they will be here, as well as the evening concerts will be happening Thursday, April the 20th, and Friday, April the 21st. So if you're interested in those evening shows, you could purchase tickets via our Instagram, the QR codes. They're a public link for everybody. Everything is School Cash Online this year. No physical tickets. So public link on School Cash Online. $10 for each show. And we want you to come to both because they're going to be amazing. So it's going to be an incredible show for our students. 10 o'clock and 12 o'clock those days. I can't tell you how excited I am to bust the kids in and have our students here as part of the feeder school performances. And then in evening shows. And they will sell out, guys. So get your tickets, please. Because, again, they are max capacity of about 570 people. And so those shows, once again, are Thursday, April the 20th, and Friday, April the 21st. As always, all this information can be found at Bishop Ryan Music on Instagram. Have a great Monday, Celtics, and we'll see you soon. Cheers.
ABR, and happy Monday. A quick announcement from Celtic Diversity that they'll be putting on a Black History Showcase tomorrow. That's Tuesday the 28th, tomorrow, at periods 2, 3, and 4 in the auditorium. We hope to see everyone there.
Good morning, Bishop Ryan. My name is Daniel, and today I am bringing you your sports announcements for today. Today, the girls' varsity hockey team will take on St. John Henry Newman in the championship game at 1 p.m. at Mountain Arena. Looking forward to seeing you there, Celtics. Any female students interested in playing indoor varsity soccer, please sign up by Gym A. Grades 9 and 10 are welcome. And finally, good luck goes out to our members of our swim team as they travel off to OFSA. That is all from me today, BR. And now on to the wrestling team.
Look at that. It turns out I'm making three different shots today in the studio. One officially, another officially, and one unofficially, because that's what I do, right? I move from shot to shot. So I am here with your Bishop Ryan Celtic wrestling team, who most recently wrestled at the GHAC Regional Tournament. And it led to our girls team placing first, our boys team placing third in a very tough and difficult field. Many of the wrestlers behind me here and beside me are our top three finishers. And nearly 12, or all 12 of them, who are going to OFSA are joining us here as well. OFSA to be in Ottawa a little bit later these coming weeks. Congratulations to our team, and congratulations to coaches Francis, Hill Francis, Vieira, Derm, and others as well along the way, too. And congratulations, of course, to our team. Now to Coach Francis for a couple words.
Sure. Thank you, Ms. Oh, no, it's good. I got it. All right. Okay, good. We're good. We're good. Everything is good. Thank you, Mr. Lawler. Yes, like Mr. Lawler said, behind me are our medalists from the GHAC Championships. Our bronze medalists, we have Isabella Rendina, grade 9, Katharina Schaefer, Shelby Vanderlip, Jasmine Nicoletta, Olivia Ciccarella, and Charlize Goodard. Our silver medalists, we have Miguel Fernandez and Josh Ramon. And our gold medalists, we have Jaden Asensio, Gabriel Giannini, Daniel Benvega, Aiden Nadelko Payne, Elma Alababa, Taylor Engel, Ella D'Almeida, Claudia Landry, and Deanna Ron. We have a wonderful girls program that was able to bring back the GHAC Championship trophy. Our boys placed third in a tough fought competition, losing to Burbuff and Craig Kilberger, which I know, I was upset about it too. I was. Meaning that the rivalry between us and Craig Kilberger is back on, which is exciting in sport. Sport rivalries are always exciting to have. Our team leaves to go to OFSA on Monday in Ottawa, where we again get to compete for a title. If it's ever happened at OFSA Wrestling, Bishop Ryan has done it. Bishop Ryan won OFSA with six boys in 1994. So we're looking at our six boys and six girls that go off to compete with us. We'll be able to do the same thing. Furthermore, I would like to thank our team, the team that's not moving on, or the rest of the team that's not moving on to OFSA. I'd like to thank them for everything that they've done and everything that they've given up and their dedication to the team. It's always saddest to try your hardest and just come up short, but to not try at all is the worst feat they can ever have. So I'm happy that they all came out and they tried to put their best foot forward. Those members of the team are still welcomed to practice as we prepare our team for their best performance at the provincial championships. And also, we have some news from some of our Bishop Ryan alumni at the U Sport, which is the National University Championships. We had alumni Elise Danes got bronze, Gianluca Fortino got bronze, Serena DiBenedetto got a silver, and Lucas Getzky got a gold at the 82 kilo weight class. So we're very happy and proud of them. And we're very happy of all of our Bishop Ryan athletes and wrestlers as we continue to strive for excellence here at Bishop Ryan. Thank you.